Welcome back to this video lecture, my dear students. Hope that by the grace of Almighty, all of you are fine. My dear students, today I want to solve a very important math from chapter number 7A, that is cost accounting, Chittagong Board 2017, math number 8. My dear students, at first we want to see the problem. The problem is the balances regarding production cost of Alum Limited for 2015 is given below. Raw material opening 14,000 taka and closing 11,000 taka. Partly finished goods or work in process opening 20,000 taka, closing 18,000 taka. Finished goods 150 units opening 35,000 taka, but closing amount is missing here. Raw material purchase 2,25,000 taka. Direct wages 1,75,000 taka. Factory overhead 1,50,000 taka. Sales 2,250 units 7,50,000 taka. Closing inventory 250 units amount is missing here. Okay, dear students. Charge administrative expenses 30% on production cost and selling expenses 7% on sales. Now requirement. Requirement A, calculate the amount of prime cost. Requirement B, calculate the amount of cost of goods sold. Requirement C, prepare income statement. Okay, dear students, now let's go to solve the math. Now solution, requirement A. Calculation the amount of prime cost. My dear students, we know that prime cost is equal to direct raw material used plus direct wages plus other direct expenses. And we also know that direct raw material used is equal to opening stock of raw materials plus purchase of raw materials minus closing stock of raw materials. So here opening stock of raw materials amount is 14,000 taka plus purchase of raw materials 2,25,000 taka. So total raw materials amount is 2,39,000 taka minus closing stock of raw materials 11,000 taka. So direct raw material used 2,28,000 taka. Now plus direct wages or direct labor amount is 1,75,000 taka. But here other direct expenses is missing. So 2,28,000 taka plus 1,75,000 taka. So prime cost amount is 4,03,000 taka. Okay, dear students. Now requirement B, calculation the amount of cost of goods sold using cost statement. Here prime cost from requirement A 4,03,000 taka plus factory overhead 1,50,000 taka. So factory cost amount is 5,53,000 taka plus opening partly finished goods 20,000 taka minus closing partly finished goods or work in process 18,000 taka. So cost of goods manufactured 5,55,000 taka plus opening finished goods 35,000 taka. Total 5,90,000 taka minus closing finished goods 58,830 taka. So cost of goods sold amount is 5,31,170 taka. Okay, dear students. My dear students, we can follow workings. Calculation of value of closing stock of finished goods. We know that value of closing stock of finished goods is equal to cost of production divided production units into closing stock of finished goods units. Here production units is equal to sales units plus closing stock of finished goods minus opening stock of finished goods. So 2,250 plus 250 minus 150 units, that is production units is 2,350 units. Okay, dear students. Now requirement C, that is income statement. My dear students, we know that through income statement we can calculate gross profit, operating profit and net profit or loss. Okay, dear students. So at first we want to calculate the amount of gross profit. Formula is sales minus cost of goods sold. Here sales amount is 7,50,000 taka minus cost of goods sold from requirement B 5,31,170 taka. So gross profit amount is 2,18,830 taka minus operating expenses. Here administrative expenses 5,53,000 into 30%, that is 1,65,900 taka. Selling expenses 7,50,000 into 7%, that is 52,500 taka. So total operating expenses amount is 2,18,400 taka. Now 2,18,830 taka minus operating expenses 2,18,400 taka. So net profit amount is 430 taka. Okay, dear student, this is the solution of requirement C. My dear students, hope that you are clearly understood. If any problem, contact to your respective class teacher. Thank you so much, my dear students.